I'm Melissa, or Nolan's mom, as some of you might know me. So before we get started today, let's take some time right now to complete your activity pages. So I want you to look at each row and pick the one good thing out of all the bad items. You can pause this video now, and I'll see you when you have finished your page. Good job choosing the good thing in each set. In our Bible story today, we will hear how one good king was followed by several bad kings. Those bad kings later became prisoners. We will hear the whole story today from the Bible. But first, let's play a game. I want everyone to stand up right in front of me. Now when I turn around, you try to sneak away from me. But when I say, turn back, and turn around, you need to turn around, face me, and freeze. If you are still moving, when I turn around, you'll have to go back to where you originally started. The goal of this game is to reach the other side of the room. Alright, let's get started! Turn back! Did I get any of you? No? Okay. Turn back! How about this time? You guys are all too good for me. You all listen so well. All right, one more time. Hopefully one of you can reach the other side of the room. Before I say, turn back! Okay.
All right, everyone, you can have a seat now. So these past few weeks, we have been learning about some of the prophets and kings who told people to turn back to God, but the people did not listen. In today's Bible story, we will learn what happened to the people who kept turning away from God. God gives us His Word in the Bible, which is the big story of how God rescues sinners through His Son Jesus. We've heard His message through prophets, so let's find out if the people listened to our Bible story from 2 Chronicles.
Hey friends, it's me, Megan,
and I'm Jesse.
Jesse, what happened to your hand?
I burned it.
Oh, you burned it? Well, goodness, how did that happen?
Well, I was helping my mom make some cheesy blueberry mashed potatoes, and she told me not to put my hand in the pot of boiling potatoes. But I just wanted a little taste, so I did it anyway, and I burned my hand.
Ouch.
Yeah, I should have listened to my mom.
You are very right. In today's Bible story, God sent prophets to warn His people to stop sinning, but the people didn't listen. Listen to the story to find out what happened.
Josiah, the king of Judah, had 3 sons, Jehoahaz, Jehoiakim, and Zedekiah. Josiah had a grandson, too. His name was Jehoiakim. Each of them had a turn at being king. None of them was good like King Josiah. After Josiah died, Jehoahaz became king. Jehoahaz was not king for very long. He did bad things that God did not like. The king of Egypt took Jehoahaz away and made him a prisoner. So Jehoahaz's brother, Jehoiakim, became king. Jehoiakim also did what was wrong. The king of Babylon took Jehoiakim away and made him a prisoner. So Jehoiakim's son, Jehoiakim, became king. Jehoiakim also did what was wrong. The king of Babylon sent some of his servants to Judah. They took Jehoiakim to Babylon. The king of Babylon made Jehoiakim's uncle king. His name was Zedekiah. Zedekiah also did what was wrong. He led God's people to do wrong things too. God loved His people. He did not want to destroy them, so He sent prophets to talk to the people. The prophet said, "Stop sinning. Turn back to God."
No.
But the people did not listen. It was time for God to punish the people of Judah for their sin. God allowed the king of Babylon and his armies to attack the people in Judah, and many of the people died. The king of Babylon took everything out of the Lord's temple and burned the temple. They tore down the wall that stood around the city of Jerusalem. The army destroyed anything that was left. The king of Babylon took the rest of the people to Babylon, and he made them work for him and his family. All of this happened just as God said it would. God was right to punish his people because they sinned, but God still loved them, and he was going to give his people a good king, just like he said he would. Many years later, God sent his son, Jesus, to be our king forever. Jesus took the punishment that we should get for our sin.
Even though King Uzziah led the people back to God and God sent prophets to warn them, Judah did not listen to God's warning. They kept doing wrong things. God allowed the Babylonians to attack his people. God was right to punish his people because they had sinned. But God still loved them. And he was going to give his people a good king. Many years later, God gave his son Jesus to be our king forever. God told his people that he would forgive them when they turned back to him, but Judah did not listen to God's warning. God was right to punish his people because they sinned. Jesus took the punishment we should get for our sin. None of the prophets, priests, or kings in our Bible stories could make people love God. So how did God plan to fix what sin broke? God planned to send Jesus. Jesus is our perfect prophet, priest, and king. Before we go, let's take a minute to pray together. Father, thank you for having a plan to fix the brokenness of sin. We know that we cannot earn the salvation you give us, so we praise you for giving it freely. Help us love and obey you. Amen. Hope you all have a great week, and I hope to see you soon.